This video, I'm going to talk about new features in the 1.30 that allows us to analyze the disk image file dynamically instead of us to pre-configure the entire flash into like 15 segments. Here, I only have the one segment configuration for the SB6190, and this it has eMMC and one big block. And I also have the backup of original file being loaded. So I load this file. And the new feature we allow added is fdisk. So this is exactly what we did on the Linux shell and analyzed the partition table of this image. In the case of we trying to program Birware or Alphaware or other testing firmware, the only thing we need to do is to replace the certain partition with the proper file. If you look at the script that we used to replace the partition, is something like this. We replace this file to the partition 5 and this same file partition 6. And this file to 7 and 8. So now I'm going to show you how to program this 6190. And I already modified the connection so we can hook up Ulink directly like we did in the last video for 1602. And currently it is in the stock. And there's no Birware. Okay, so let's unplug it, unplug the USB, and then connect the Ulink NT to it, and plug the USB in it. So now I'm going to run the script. This Birware script has been modified, only backup and the restore and program for Birware. Now, the only thing needed is preloaded the existing firmware, which will allow us to analyze the flash table or the partition table. So let's select the program Birware. I also need to point the current folder to the 1.0.5.9. And now I select 3. So first it will execute the fdisk, which will create the partition tables. And then we can say, make sure this partition table does show up. Otherwise, we may need to look at why we do not have the partition table. Either need to read back or need to load to the memory. And then we can make sure the flash status is correct. So now we can hit enter. So if you look at the command, we load RAM, instead of the address, we say the 5 image to this file and 6 and so on. The program is 5 image and this file. This file, and we only look at this one is to check the proper size. So this will give you the address and this will give the size of the place we need to program. By using this script, the programming time is much shorter because we only program the necessary size. So the same script should work for the 256 meg of flash, even though I have not yet tested, but I'm pretty sure this will work as well. For some reason, this USB port when writing is much faster than the other ports. And this gives me close to 1 megabyte per second in writing. So programming finished. So now let's unplug it and remove the USB. So power on the modem. Okay, we got the IP address. Now let's go to the, and we see it. Let's see if the bitware is programmed. It programs the bitware as well. So I'm going to try another one with the alphaware. Let's restore it first. So restore it first. Okay, it is restored. Now let's exit and point this to the alphaware, which is here. Now let's call the script called alpha and program the alphaware, which is 3. First, we make sure the partition table is correct. Then we detect it's right. So let's program it. Okay, finish programming. Let's unplug it. And remove the USB. Power on the modem and hook up the network cable. Okay, now let's go back to here and check the firmware. You see, this is alphaware. I hope the feature of 1.30 improve the performance of programming firmware on other eMMC devices.